All right, guys, let's get right into it today. We're going to be diving into how I make the Mood Board Monday videos that I post every Monday on UMDAKO. I will put them up on the screen right now, the last three that I did. And today we're going to be doing a fourth one. So I'm going to open a project that I work out of often. You can either make a new project or reopen a project. And then for me, I have a bin, which is also called a folder, if you remember from last time, called Mood Board Mondays, that I will find now. Here we go. And then I'm gonna make a new bin or folder titled Mood Board Monday 1227, because that is what day it is today. All right, so either you remember from last time, we can create a new sequence, or if we're feeling lazy, we can go into an older sequence that we know we have the right, we know it's the right 16 by 9 size that we like so much, and we can just copy that, which is Control C and Control V it, right into our new folder, Mood Board Monday 1227, and then I'm gonna retitle it Mood Board Monday 1227 so I don't get confused up here in the sequence tabs, Mood Board Monday 1227, and then I'm going to double click that and open it, and then here's a new shortcut alert. We're gonna hit Command A if you're on a Mac. If you're on a PC, I don't know. And that Command A is going to select everything within your sequence right here. It is the same shortcut as if you were in like Google Docs and you did Command A. So if you're on a PC and you know how to select everything in like a Microsoft Word document, it's gonna be that shortcut and you're gonna delete it. And the other thing that you can see up here are these little green tabs. We're going to get rid of those too. So I just right clicked up in this like little gray space right here, right click clear all markers, because we're gonna wanna make new markers with our new song that we're gonna use in this one. So now Command I to open this import tab, select everything that I just airdropped to myself and bring it into Beautiful. And I'm going to get rid of that one because that's for later. Make sure I have everything that I wanted. Yay. All right. So if you're reusing things you've used in past sequences, what's great about working on multiple sequences in the same project is you can go into that old sequence and pull it. So for example, this is always the background for the Mood Board Mondays that we make. So I can just pull that out of an old sequence and bring it over here. So I'm going to drag and drop that into our project. So the next thing you're gonna wanna do is music. If you wanna pull a TikTok audio or a Instagram Reel audio, you're either gonna screen record the TikTok or the Instagram Reel, or you're gonna save it to your phone, airdrop, and just pull the audio, simple as that. For me, I'm going to search a song. I know what I wanna do, what song I wanna do, so I'm gonna find it on YouTube. And I'm going to totally, not illegally, download it to my computer. Now, I like to download it as an MP4 file, which MP4 is a video. I like to download it as an MP4 because every once in a while, you're gonna find that the MP3 that you get from these sketchy websites is not compatible with Premiere Pro for whatever reason. And so I like to just avoid even finding out that step by just going with the MP4. So now I'm gonna Command I, open up that import, it's right here. And I'm gonna scrub, I'm gonna double click on the file that I just imported. And I'm going to scrub through to where I want the audio to start. So let's start.
This is a journey into sound.
Okay, so I'm gonna use my arrow keys on my keyboard to just scroll over just a smidge, because I know that, right, perfect. So that's exactly where I want it. So now I'm gonna hit the I. And then I'm gonna take this whole thing, which obviously I'm gonna use about 15 seconds of it, the whole thing, and pull it in. And when you change the I in that original thing right here, in that original file from your project, it starts it right where you want when you pull it in. So if I hadn't done the I and I had pulled it in, it would have pulled it in right from the default beginning. But since we changed where the beginning is, it's gonna start right where I want it. So let's listen now. All All right, so perfect. That's exactly where I want it. So I'm gonna hit my C tool, which is my cut right here, and I'm going to cut the audio, V back to select, and I'm going to select the rest and delete it. So now we have 10 seconds that we are working with, which is perfect for socials. Obviously, if this is for personal use or for something else, you can make it as long or short as you'd like. So we're gonna keep that volume on and we are going to listen to the beat one more time because playing with the music is the key to making these kind of cohesive and look cool. So let's listen one more time. All right, so that's what we're working with right now. We are going to use those markers that we deleted previously. The shortcut to add a marker is going to be the letter M on your keyboard. There we go. See a marker. I'm going to Command-Z and remove that. But we are going to use those markers to kind of place where we want the pictures to flow onto the screen, because you'll notice in my past videos, they tend to go with the beat. And going with the beat just adds an extra oomph into your video. So let's listen one more time. You can listen to it as many times as you want to really feel the rhythm, because the last time you listen to it, you're gonna place the markers and I'll show you how. So I'm gonna listen to it one more time and then I'm gonna play back and I'm gonna do the markers without talking in between because it messes me up. So one more time and then add the markers. All right. All right, so I just added all my markers. So now I'm gonna mute it. I don't need to listen to the music for the rest of the time. I can just play with my pictures. I know exactly where the beat is because I selected it here in my markers. So now we are going to play with the pictures that we found, however you found them, and let's make some collages. So the first collage I'm gonna make, I'm just actually gonna work in order. I'm gonna pull this one. So all you're doing is you're placing your photos on your timeline. I'm actually going to lock my V1 so that I don't move my background at all. So you're placing your photos on your timeline. You are pinching in and out with your pointer and middle finger and just collaging those as you'd like to. You can even rotate them. So that's either spinning with your pointer and index finger, or you can go into your effect controls that we remember from our last video and fidgeting with the rotate option here. I think I'm going to rotate it like that. And I know that 270, thanks to freshman year math, I know 270 means that it is straight. So I'm gonna do that. And you know what? I really want that picture of the city to be on top of my hamburger picture. So you know what I'm gonna do? My picture of the city is in V2, my hamburger picture is in V3. I'm gonna flip those. So I'm gonna put my picture of the city in V4 and my hamburger picture in V2 so that my picture in the city is on top. And you can keep fidgeting with that as you go. So this picture of Sarah and Brooke is gonna go right here. And this picture of Emma and Julia is gonna go underneath all of these. And it's gonna go up in the top corner there. Yep. And then I'm gonna look for another scenic picture with no people in it, not the food one. We have already have food. Let's go for this one. And we are gonna put, so I'm gonna select all of these by, I'm gonna put my cursor here in the gray where there's no media instead of here. And I'm gonna select as if there was media here and hold the select down with your left or right hand. And with your opposite hand, you are going to drag and select all of this and then just shift it up one, because I want this picture, Gabby's picture of grass, I want that to be in the back here. And so now you see you have a nice little collage. Nothing crazy, it's just a nice little collage. But now this is how I make the video, the Mood Board Monday video, is I'm going to place the beginning of each of these pictures at one of these markers. So the first one is gonna be right here and that's gonna start at the beginning of the video. The second one, I'm going to drag, it's gonna start there. third one I'm going to drag over. It's going to start there. And now, you know what? I'm going to take the sixth one. Well, technically it's the fifth one because we locked V1, so it's as if it's not there. But the fifth or sixth one, and I'm going to drag that one here. And then the fifth one, or the fourth, I'm going to drag here. So now it's not exactly in order, so we'll see as you play that it doesn't come in. The layers of the video are not in order as they appear, so you kind of get a nice surprise, one could say, with each addition. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna once again do the trick where I select where nothing is, I keep it held down with one hand, and with my opposite hand I drag to select all of these, and I'm just gonna extend that to the end of the video, because what's fun about Mood Board Monday is all of them build on each other. But I don't want my already built mood board to distract me when I'm building a new one. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna scroll down in my project files here, and I'm going to place this picture as just a placeholder on top of the mood board I just built so that I can't see it. So now I'm gonna keep looking through these pictures here. So let's start off with Nia's cookie picture. And this is gonna be the same process for each one. So you're gonna stop hearing from me while I build this, and I will check back in with you guys at the end. All right, so quick check in here. Once you have built your new mood board, you are going to do the same thing you did last time. So you're gonna see where that last, so this marker here is where that last picture on my first mood board was in. So we're gonna go into the next marker, and that's where my new mood board's gonna start. One thing is, once you are done, so don't forget that this image here was your placeholder image, so dragging that was actually a mistake. Don't forget that this image here is actually a placeholder image. So after you're done building your mood board, you're gonna do the same step where you select everything and drag it all the way down, and you're gonna delete this. You don't need this anymore. So just don't forget that. All right, so once again, you're deleting this here, and then you are selecting everything and you are dragging it. And don't forget, every time that this view changes, it's because I am pinching with my middle and pointer finger and making the timeline bigger or smaller, which is something you can also do with this scroller right here at the bottom. And then I'm just gonna drag all of these down while they're still selected, because don't forget, this channel was taken up by the placeholder before we built our next one. So now I'm gonna bring my cursor to the place where the last picture in the mood board is put in, and I'm going to go back to my placeholder image and put it right in there. This is a super simple task that does not have to be overcomplicated in the slightest. It can get a little bit time consuming, but it really isn't something that requires too much familiarity with the editing software. All right, so you'll see here that I was trying to select all of these, and I just couldn't quite get everything in the same timeline with my cursor. So the other thing you can do is, if you have four pictures selected, you need to select five, you're just gonna hit the shift button before you go in and select that final picture, and then same effect. All right, so now that we have reached the end, we are going to go through with our C tool here, and we are just gonna cut everything at this marker head right here. And you can see there are a few times in between mood boards where I forgot to drag my videos down to cover the video channel where my placeholder clip was, and that is perfectly fine. It's not gonna affect your final video. It just means you have more channels open, which can sometimes slow down your computer and it gets frustrating. And now we're just gonna use our select by holding down on the cursor and with our other hand dragging up, and we are just deleting all of this extra right here. Now, this is a personal preference. Usually at the end of my video, I like to do a little clip with all the final mood boards getting their own little spot in the sun. And so the way that I do that is I hit the little squiggly slash dash. I will put a little picture of what key I'm talking about here, but it's the one next to the one button on your keyboard, and that is going to make whatever you have selected full screen. So for example, I have this, as you can see, this blue, thin blue line over my timeline here. So now once I click that, it's full screen. So what I want is I want this to be full screen. So I'm going to select that, and now I'm going to scrub through right here to find where my mood boards ended. So for example, that's one, and I'm going to Command Shift 4, which is how we take a screenshot on a Mac. And I'm going to screenshot that, and now keep scrubbing through to where our final mood board is on this one, which is right here. Once again, Command Shift 4, screenshot, and we're gonna do that for all of them. And when we do that, we might find a mistake like this. And that is when we're gonna hit that button next to the one again, and we are gonna find what went wrong that this picture of soul did not get covered by whatever we wanted it to get covered up by. So let's look. So we want that, right, but I don't want this. So this is where we find out that everything is accidentally a playhead off. It's gonna happen, it's frustrating, and so what we're gonna do is we are going to have to just go through everything and just push it one. So this is here, and we're gonna wanna push it one over. And what's extra frustrating about this is we're gonna have to pull everything over, because it looks like we might even be two playheads off, which is really unfortunate. So we're once again selecting, and we're gonna drag this out a few. We're gonna see here. So is this sharing a playhead? Yes. Is this sharing a playhead? Three times. So we need to move that, and we need to move that. And this is sharing a playhead, which means we need to move this over here. Great. And if you couldn't tell, that great was sarcastic. All right, so now we need everything to end on this playhead. So, kind of happy I made that mistake, so that if you do, which I do almost every time, you know how to fix it. So great. Now we're just once again holding down with one finger, so dragging with the other finger, selecting everything and having it end at this playhead as opposed to the one prior. So great, great, great. All right, so let's start perfect. Let's start here. Let's hit that button again next to our one, and let's scroll through and see. Perfect. So now we're gonna screenshot that and so on. Hopefully everything is fine. All right, great. So now we have our four collages. I'm going to hit that button again next to the one to exit full screen. Now we have our four collages, and you're going to see we actually only have one, or maybe two if you want to count the end of the video as another playhead. One or two are going to unlock this here. One or two places where we're going to put our final mood boards in. And obviously we have more than four. So I'm actually going to select both this video here and this here, once again, using my hold down and scroll method on my keypad. I'm going to Command I import those screenshots I just took, which will be right here. So Shift up arrow and select all of those, hit the enter button, and they're imported. And we're gonna see that I have five mood boards to fit in here. So now I'm gonna turn my volume back on, and we are going to try to create five more spaces to put in those mood boards. I'm gonna start from a little bit before, so that I can get a feel for the rhythm again, and then I'm gonna place those markers where I need them. All right, great. So now we have over five places to put our markers. So now that we have extra room, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to leave this space here as a blank space. So now I'm gonna scrub bring this first mood board in, and we're going to see it's a little bit bigger than our sequence ratio frame. It's a little bit bigger than our sequence's frame, and so we're going to see I like it right there. And so that is at scale 81.3, so I'm going to Command C and copy that scale because I'm lazy. And now I'm bringing in the second sequence here just by doing this. I'm not 100% sure if this is actually my second mood board, but I don't care. So now we can see here it's a little bit big, so I'm going to go into the effect controls of this picture scale. I'm going to select the scale. You can see the 100 is highlighted. I'm going to Command V in that 81.3 so that each mood board is the same size. And same thing for every single one of those. Now you're going to see that with the beat, it was like bum, ba, bum, bum. And you can see that that mood board gets absolutely no time. So I'm actually gonna skip that little beat here. It should be fine because these two are also beats. So I'm just gonna skip that little one because since I'm trying to show something for a longer amount of time, we don't wanna just show it for that long. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Perfect. And we're gonna put that one. We're gonna do the same thing where we skip that little offbeat right there. And we are going to, all right, great. Now let's watch it all the way through with the music. Now, did you see how it was kind of like, wait, was it with the beat? Was it not with the beat? I can't tell. So what we're going to do is we're going to sequence render into out. It's going to take a little bit of time, but in doing this, we're kind of cheating the buffering. We're having the video load all the way through so that when we watch it, so I didn't love that, if I'm going to be honest. I wasn't obsessed. And so I am going to go through. I'm going to speed up this process a little bit for you guys here. I'm going to mute myself. You'll just listen to some elevator music. And I'm going to go through and I'm going to really nitpick about where the beats are, because for me, I didn't love that. And I'm the type of person that likes to edit right on the beat. You can stop listening to me now and you can just watch me go through and just do millisecond edits here to try to make it more on the beat. And you might see me delete the playhead markers and put them in again. All I'm doing is that same process that you guys are familiar with, where I'm clearing the markers and then hitting that M shortcut key to put them back in. Sequence render into out as to avoid buffering, and let's watch my new cut, see if we can. I think I do like it more. My one thing is, I think I saw somewhere around here that things came on at the same time, which is not something that we like. So let's investigate. And you can jump playhead to playhead here by just selecting a marker, and it'll bring the playhead right to where your marker is. And then you can see, did two images come up at once? And they did. Which is unfortunate, because you know what that means. It means we have to push everything back one. We have to do the end thing again. Maybe if you're a double checker, unlike me, you don't run into this constant battle with fixing your own work. Unfortunately, I do have that battle. And so I will speed up this process. You will stop hearing from me for a minute while I fix something that you guys know how to fix, because I fixed it twice already in this one video. Last try, I think this is it here. I think that is what my great aunt Eileen would say is done enough. And so we are going to file export that project. and I'm going to keep that title, and I'm just gonna double check and make sure it's going where I want it to. Yep, export it.